Δόξα σοι ο Θεός ημών, δόξα σοι Χριστός, ο αληθινός Θεός ημών, δεσπευρίζεις παναπνάω και παναμαγεύσω του Μητρός, δυνάμει του Δημήτρια του Ζωμίου Σταυρού, προστασίες του Δημήτρια Κορονίου των άμυνα σωμάτων, ηγεσίες του Δημήτρια Δόξα Λοχή του Προδρόμου και Βαπτιστού Ιωάννου, των Αγίων Εδόξων και Παναθήνων Αποστόλων, των Αγίων Εδόξων και Φαλνίκων Μαρτύρων, των Οσίων και Θεοδόρων Πατρονικών, του Αγίου Γεωργίου του Τροπεοφόρου, των Αγίων και Δικαίων Θεοπατρών Ιωκήμ και Άνης, του Αγίου Λαβρεντίου, του Μάρτυρος και Αρχιδιακόνου, ού και την μνήμη επιτελούμεν και πάνω των Αγίων, ελέησε και σώσε ημάς, ως αγαθός και φιλάνθρωπος.
Thank you. special pleasure to have the children. They were dancing next door, so we did a small, a little piece of the small Paraklesis before we started. It was nice to see children again in the church, especially in the summer, always nice. There is a hymn that we're going to chant August 15th for Panagia. It's the instead of the Axionistim, we chant the ninth ode. That's special when it's a big holiday. Nenikin de disvisios iori en sipa parthene achate. I'll just focus on this first phrase. In you, theologos, the limits of nature are defeated. You know, the nature cannot contain the Panagia. Of course, it's referring to her death and her metastasis. We don't refer to it as resurrection, even though that's pretty much what it is. Jesus took her body and soul to heaven, and she's alive now. But metastasis means moved, you know, from one place to another. Of course, I'll add the parentheses that we call it dormition in our faith, and many call it assumption in other denominations and in the Catholic religion. It is assumption, even though the Orthodox teaching and belief is that she was assumed into heaven by Jesus Christ. It wasn't called the assumption. It was called the dormition, which means the falling asleep of Mary. Close parentheses. So with this hymn, it also tells us that anything that we are bound by, any challenges we have in our life, whether they be physical or spiritual, through the Panagia, just like she overcame death through the fire she put inside her, through her belief and through the wondrous gift God gave her and her acceptance of this gift, she overcame even death itself. In the same way, we too are given this blessing when we're close to Panagia and we're close to God, of overcoming anything. And for St. George, and as I mentioned the youth before, for St. George, having the youth fill the church again, of course, is something that we are, number one, challenged by, because there is not much youth in this church right now. But at the same time, all things are possible with God through His mother, through Panagia. And so next year, it is our hope to have a greater youth program, maybe a summertime camp where for 1 week the children can come. We can have a couple of trips involved as well, kind of like a vacation Bible school, how they call it in America. For instance, my nephew is in St. Nicholas in Flushing right now, where Lucy's mama is, and it's called Panagia's Garden. His review is 10 out of 10. So imagine that. Imagine our youth in the future giving us and their time here with us, their time with God, their time with Panagia during this time, next year and in the future years, giving us a 10 out of 10. That will definitely be a miracle and no limits with God and Panagia's help. So we pray for a vibrant youth, a good Sunday school program in the future, a good dance program, a good everything program for the youth, and the ministry of the church to continue. See, I'm doing my part for the youth. We already have one going for us. God bless you all. We will now chant the